already. Sorry, we are a little few minutes late, but it promises to be a very interesting conversation on a subject that is so important to all of us. Job loss, income loss, something that COVID brought with it, apart from a risk to our life, to our health, it also brought with it a significant loss of income, loss of jobs. Hopefully, things are getting better now, but it's the new normal that these kind of events can happen at any point of time, not in our control. Job losses, income losses can happen due to a pandemic or due to any other reason. And therefore, how can we protect ourselves from something which is not in our control? And that is the essence of insurance. Sajja Praveen Chaudhary, who heads the motor insurance business and also now heads the new product line business of Policybazaar, is joining me. Sajja, what is the new innovation? We earlier had disability covers, we had even riders pertaining to a loss of income or loss of job, but what is this new innovation that you have come up with?
So basically, Vivek, there have been certain products which are there in the market which take care of certain things, whether it's job loss or income loss. But unfortunately, I guess, those have not been available to end consumers, given that either for multiple reasons. One being, probably the premium that the customers pay in such products are very, very small in nature. So, I think it might be difficult for some of the distribution channels in the market, like agents and others, also to distribute it, because if someone is to, basically pay, say, 200 rupees and take a 1 year insurance, and let's say your agent is supposed to go to someone's house, explain them the product, get the proposal form filled up, then get the policy issued, and then at the end of the day, the agent is going to earn on 200 rupees policy at 20 or 30 rupees. So I think that's also not economically viable, and as a result, I guess some of these policies not been made so famous or not been sold so widely in the market earlier. So what we've done, Vivek, is that, in this case, we've curated such plans from various insurance companies by looking at which kind of products exactly suit which kind of consumers, or what kind of products have the best of the benefits which the customer needs, kind of. And then we brought it to one platform, which is what we're calling as loss of job insurance or loss of income insurance. So this has two categories broadly. One is the loss of job insurance, the other is the loss of income insurance. The loss of job insurance, the way it works primarily is if you are a salaried person and if you have a running loan which has an EMI that you're paying for, then you can opt for a loss of job insurance. What happens in this is, let's assume you have a running job, you have a running EMI and a loan, and then the company terminates you or asks you to leave because the company is shut down or the project is shut down or for any other reasons, except for a scenario of poor performance or your own resignation. Leaving that aside, if you're asked to leave, and then in such a scenario, what this plan takes care of is it takes care of your next 3 months of EMI. So predominantly, let's assume you have a 50,000 rupees salary, and then you're having a loan which has a 20,000 rupees of EMI a month. That's what generally we see in every middle class income family in India, right? So you might have some bit of savings with you, which can take care of you for the next few months to run your family and stuff, but the EMI limit of 20,000 plus the expenses put together, that might be a kind of a financial burden for consumers. Hence, what these plans would take care of is the next 3 months of EMI, at least you need not pay, or the company will pay you and you can take care of the payment from there on. And the assumption is generally within 3 months, someone would be able to find a job and so on and so forth. And that's an average tenure which is taken. That's how these plans are designed today. So these are the plans which are available, where probably you can buy it at about, let's say, 1,500, 1,600 rupees a year is what you pay. And you can get covered for 20,000 rupees or 15,000 rupees EMI for 3 months, up to 3 months. Then the second category of plans are loss of income plans. What happens today, Vivek, is that at times there are scenarios which happen where you have an accident or an accidental incident, and then disablement occurs with you. Disablement in the sense you have to take a bed rest for 6 months, you cannot move your legs, you cannot go to office, you cannot make work. And what happens in a general scenario is every company has a leave policy, right? You have a sick leave which might be for 15 days, 1 month, whatever it might be, and after that you go into a leave without pay. And which means you don't have any income for the next 6 months or that period where you're not going to office. And it's not only for people who are salaried, but even for self-employed people also. You have a business which you're going to run, you have a shop to run, and the shop is going to pay you 50,000 rupees, or the shop is giving you 50,000 rupees of income every month. And now you can't run the shop because you cannot get out of bed. So in such scenarios, what happens is the loss of income plans predominantly ensures that you are paid a income which is equal to your salary or a weekly income kind of, and basis that you know the insurance company pays you for the next 2 years a weekly income or till the time that you get better, whichever is earlier. So let's say you get better in 6 months, then they pay you for 6 months. You get better in 2 years, then they pay you for 2 years. You get better in 3 years, then they limit the payment to 2 years. So they pay you a weekly income, which is equal to your weekly salary or weekly income as on date. And that will predominantly, you know, take care of any kind of expenses that you have in such a scenario. So these might be very rare in incidents also, that you might not have an accident or accidental disability or a disablement. But at the same time, the plans also come at as low as about 150, 200 rupees a year. So if you know you need to pay about 200, 250 rupees a year and then cover yourself for, you know, say 10,000 rupees per week kind of an income. So that's awesome, right? So that's how these plans are kind of. The only difference is that, you know, there are some of the plans we are available with these as riders. And today, even some of the plans that we curated also have this as one of the feature in that plan. But the way we curated the plans are where you need not pay a very high premium to just get this benefit. Normally, what happens in an accidental plan is you'll have this income disablement on disablement, you getting a weekly income for the next 2 years. But then, you know, if you want a, say, let's assume if you want a, you know, 50,000 rupees of weekly income, which means 2 lakh rupees of monthly salary is what you're assuming. In such a case of 50,000 rupees of weekly income, you'll be required to take a plan which has a 50,000 rupees of weekly income means you need to take a plan with a 50 lakh rupees of accidental death benefit, which might cost you, say, about 10,000 rupees or 15,000 rupees. Versus, in this case, you can take a 50,000 weekly benefit at about just about 2,500 rupees or 2,600 rupees. So that's the difference that we are speaking about, right? It becomes much more affordable with the benefit that actually the customer wants, rather than, you know, just, you know, going for a plan which has a lot of other stuff also and is going to cost you a bomb.
Okay, I do have a few questions on that, but we've also received, Sajja, a lot of questions from viewers, and I think our first priority is, of course, to answer all viewer questions. So let's jump in straight. Some of what you said, you might need to reiterate.
Sure.
Also joining in, so lots of questions. Dilip Kumar, Anil Kumar Patel have this question, which you just did talk a little about, how job loss insurance works. I think I heard you mention that this is for only salaried people and only if you have an EMI. What if you don't have an EMI?
Okay, so basically, you know, the job loss insurance is predominantly for those people, which is only for EMI, if you have an EMI in place. So predominantly, you know, today we don't have plans in the country, in India, which would generally, you know, take care of your salary also kind of at this point of time on a retail platform. So if you have an EMI which is running, you can at least take care of that cover, and the rest of the part, I think you'll have to look at from, you know, basically covering basis from your existing financial savings and other stuff. However, on a self-employed segment, yes, there is a product which one of the plan also covers self-employed people, but this is in scenarios where, let's assume you're doing a business and your business, the place of business, has to be shut down because of natural calamity or, you know, flooding or whatever reason. Let's assume for the next 1 month, you have to shut down your business place. So in such cases, your monthly income the monthly EMI is taken care of for the 1 month or 3 months, up to maximum 3 months. So that plan also exists, but that is just one-off plan which is there for self-employed people in parallel, when you draw parallel to a loss of job plan kind of thing. But yes, for a loss of job plan, having a EMI is must, having a loan and an EMI is must. That's how the plans are segregated as on date. But what we're looking at in the future is probably, you know, as and when these plans, you know, start to become famous and people start to get into these and taking these, I think that's where things will start to change in the industry also, is what we expect. That there might be some products that might come in future which would actually take care of your entire salary component and need not be the EMI part as such.
So as of now, what you're saying is they're covering your liability. Any debt?
Yes, absolutely. The additional liability, the external liability that we're speaking about, yes.
And is there any specific loan which is covered, or it could be anything? It could be personal loan, it could be...
It could be a personal loan, it could be a home loan, it could be a car loan. The only thing is the loan should be from, you know, basically a authorized bank or a finance company. It cannot be, you know, an unauthorized loan that you would have taken from a friend or, you know, something that does not have documents or you know, the local lending that happens. These kind of loans obviously are not covered because, you know, I think it's a very, very niche category, and it's just about, you know, starting off a segment. So I think we haven't as a country progress there to see the authenticity of certain loans and what is there and what's not. So I think over a period of time, probably things will get there. But as on date, yes, the only restriction is that these loans have to be from a proper, you know, bank or a finance company. That's how it is.
Okay. Amber Diwan seems to have a question. Amber, can you post your question on the chat window so we can all see it? I'm sorry, I can't seem to see your question. I only see a question mark from you. Okay. Here's a question coming in from Vinay Kumar Tripathi. How can I buy the insurance and what are the conditions attached to it?
Okay. So basically, you know, we have this option available on PolicyBazaar website. You can choose loss of job income insurance. And then once you put in your details with respect to, you know, whether you're salaried, self-employed, and whether you have a loan or not, you will get personalized quotes which are as per your income and so on and so forth. You can obviously modify the income benefit as per the limits that are available there, the weekly income benefit, in case you're looking for a weekly income benefit. Or in case we're looking at for loss of job plan, the obviously the basis, the EMI that you've declared, the benefit will be shown and the premium will be shown. All that you have to do is you have to, you know, just select it, and there are a few details to be filled out, which are like, you know, basically details about yourself, your name, your address, your date of birth, nominee details, and basic things about your bank, which bank do you have the loan from, and what is the loan account number, and what is the loan amount, and so on and so forth. And you can get an instant policy. Only a couple of insurers, I guess, have a, you know, requirement of even uploading a document. All that you have to do is, you know, you basically you have to upload a loan statement or loan disbursement letter that you might have, a copy of it, and then you'll get a policy immediately, kind of.
So Anil Patel has a follow-up question. Premium frequency and amount. What is the premium frequency and the amount?
So the premium frequency, these plans at this point of time are on an annual basis. So there aren't monthly or, you know, half yearly at this point of time on these plans. We can figure out and explore these along with insurance companies as we move forward. From a premium perspective, I was just giving a couple of examples earlier, right? So, you know, for someone who might have a 15,000, 20,000 rupees of EMI, I guess these plans come to you about roughly about 1600 rupees a year kind of premium. So you pay 1600 rupees once in a year. Basically, you're covered for 3 months of EMI worth 15,000-20,000 rupees in case of a loss of job. The only condition that exists in loss of job insurance to an extent, or a couple of conditions that you need to take care of. One is in case of resignation, your self-resignation because you're looking for some other job or for whatever reason it might be. Or in cases of, you know, termination due to poor performance and fraud and dishonesty and all of these things are not covered as part of this plan. The second thing is whenever you take a plan, the first 3 months are a waiting period in loss of job insurance. This is not applicable to loss of income. This is applicable to loss of job insurance. Loss of job insurance, the first 3 months are a waiting period when you're taking the plan for the first ever time. So let's assume you're taking it this year and you're going to renew it for the next 4 years because you have a 5-year loan, let's assume. So only this year, the first 3 months are a waiting period, which means if you lose job within this 3 months, then it's not covered. But anytime post this 3 months and you keep renewing timely for the next 5 years, anytime you claim, let's assume this year take in December, next year December again you renew, and let's assume next in January the other year, the following year you lose a job, then you'll be covered. 3 months waiting period will not be applicable on renewal, timely renewal. It's only for the first ever time. So there's a condition that you need to remember. And whereas when you come to loss of income insurance, as I told you just slightly right now, if you're looking at, you know, something like say a 5,000 or 10,000 rupees or even a 10,000 rupees of weekly benefit. Which means if you have a salary of 40,000 rupees a month or income of 40,000 rupees a month and you're looking at 10,000 rupees of weekly benefit kind of, then, you know, that might come to you about roughly 500, 600 rupees a year. Once a year, you have to pay 500 rupees, 600 rupees. If you're, let's assume your salary is about 2 lakh rupees a month and or income is 2 lakh rupees a month and you're looking at 50,000 rupees per week benefit kind of, then I think the premium would come to about roughly 2,600, 2,700 rupees a year, once in a year. That's how it is.
There's a very interesting question from Ram Narey. Anil, of course, has a couple of follow-up questions, but I'll take this one first. He says, generally in companies, one is asked to resign rather than termination. This would be almost 90% in that case, and that's very correct, actually. What would then be the situation? Would a person insured not get the policy or the
insurance? That's an interesting one because, you know, there are two kinds of categories which you can broadly divide currently any kind of termination and all of that into, right? So let me categorize into two parts. One is, let's assume the you know, layoffs that happened, you know, when a company is shut down. For example, I think in the past there are a few airlines which have shut down, right? And the airline shut down all of a sudden. Someday they were running all of a sudden, and then one day they shut down. That's it. People did not get salaries. People did not get anything, and the company's out. That's it. In those scenarios, absolutely, this plan will pay automatically, because you know there's no resignation, there's nothing. It's termination. It's a company closure and all of that stuff happening, right? And this is not only with airlines. I think this happened with multiple other companies also. Some of the e-commerce companies had this kind of thing in the past, where the funding dried out, and absolutely the company shut down or the project shut down, and things happened. That's in those scenarios you're covered 100%. Now let's assume other category or you know other segment, where let's assume your company is kind of you know asking people to leave because they want to save on costs and certain things, and they say, you know, here is the deal, I'm giving you, you know, next 3 months of salary or 6 months of salary. That's generally what happens in such kind of scenarios. The company generally pays as per labor laws and other stuff also. They have certain obligations and they also pay you for the next 3 months or 6 months or till then you find a job and so on and so forth. In such scenarios, if you're resigning, then obviously this is not applicable because, you know, you're resigning, right? You're not being terminated or your company is not asking you to leave and you don't have that letter. Now you can say, why is insurance not going to cover it? Because it's a paying premium and insurance should cover it. But you know, you have to understand the one part of it. Insurance is not there generally in anywhere, whether it's car insurance, life insurance, anything. It's not there to profit. It's there to take care of any loss that might incur to you at that point of time. So let's assume your salary is 50,000 rupees a month. The company says, oh, here is the deal. Please go out and find another job. For the next 3 months, we're going to pay you 50,000 rupees per month. Here is 1.5 lakh rupees termination. But you know, actually on paper, you have to resign. So which means you've resigned and you've got that 1.5 lakh rupees of money in your hand, which means it's going to take care of you for the next 3 months. So insurance does not kick in there, because insurance is not about giving you extra money. Insurance is about taking care of any loss that might happen to you, financial loss that might happen to you at that point of time. So from that perspective, in such scenario, it will not cover. Versus let's assume in the other scenario where the company shut down or they say, you know, you can go, this is here is your terminal letter because, you know, our project is shut down and so on and so forth. And all the company is just shut down and you have nowhere to go. In all such scenarios, obviously, you know, this plan will come and, you know, take care of you kind of.
Mm-hmm. Anil Patel has another question. In case of insured death, any benefit for the family in the running policy?
So there are, you know, the plans, as I said, right, there are other benefits which are there within these plans. The way I just mentioned about the loss of income plans, which give you on disablement the weekly benefit. Apart from, there's also an accidental death benefit that is part of it, which in case of an accidental death happening, the amount is mentioned. Some plans have those 5 lakh rupees or 1 lakh rupees and so on and so forth. That's mentioned along with these quotes. You can see those when you're trying to opt for a plan. Similarly, loss of job plans, there are also critical illness covers, which will cover you up to the loan amount as well. So if you have a 5 lakh rupees loan, which is also giving you, which has an EMI of 20,000 rupees, the way this plan works is, in case of loss of job, you paid this 3 months of EMI. And in case of, you know, basically, you know, a death or let's assume it's not even a death. Let's assume the critical illness happens. Critical illness occurs to you and you're hospitalized due to critical illness. In that case, the 5 lakh rupees is paid also. And also a couple of plans also have, along with it, accidental death covered. So as I said, the plans, while they cover your loss of job for EMI and loss of income for monthly salary or weekly income kind of, there are also other benefits which are there along with these plans. So when you're selecting a plan, you will be able to see all those benefits. What else is covered? And whatever that I'm referring to broadly is within the same premium that, you know, whatever I quoted earlier in the examples.
There is a couple of other questions as well. Dinesh Kumar has this question. How to choose which job loss plan is better? What are the factors one should keep in mind? How many insurance companies, Sajja, are offering this?
So basically, you know, there are about four companies which are offering, you know, loss of job insurance right now. And the loss of income is about coming from about 5 to 6 companies. So these two categories. From, you know, with respect to choosing, I guess, broadly, the plans are similar within these 3-4 companies, in these 3 companies at least. One, obviously, you know, what is giving you the best of premium. That's one factor which I'm sure people would look at, which is giving you the best premium out of all the 3 companies or 4 companies that is there. At the same time, the other things that you can look at is within the same premium, what are the other benefits that this company is giving? Okay, they're taking care of your 20,000 rupees EMI for 3 months, all 3 plans. But some plan might be covering you for critical illness for your loan amount also. Some plan might be covering you for critical illness as well as accidental death for your loan amount also, which means in case of accidental death happening, also your family will get the 5 lakh immediately. So the loan is cleared off, right? Or in case you have a critical illness, which might be, you know, related to cancer or a heart attack kind of stuff, then also the 5 lakh rupees of loan is paid off and, you know, your family is taken. So that's how broadly it is. So you can compare between one is the premium and the other is the features which are there apart from the basic thing. And third thing obviously is, in case if you have any brand preference from insurance company perspective, that, you know, someone likes a particular types of brands, or, you know, someone, you know, looks for certain things in terms of a young brand, someone looks for an elder brand, so on and so forth.
Anil Patel seems to be satisfied with all his answers. He's saying after meeting is over, please call me regarding policy so you can get somebody from your team, Sajjar, to get in touch with him. Anthony Mendes has this question. What are the benefits attached to job income loss insurance?
Anthony, as I said, right, you know, in a job loss insurance, the main benefit is about the EMI that you're paying. The company will take care of the EMI for up to three months or till the time you get your job back, whichever is earlier. And in case of an income loss, in case of an accidental disablement, as I said, the company will be paying your weekly benefit, which you can choose up to your weekly salary amount. So let's assume your salary is about 40,000 rupees a month, then you can select up to 10,000 rupees of weekly benefit. And in case of accidental disablement happening, they will pay you per week 10,000 rupees for the next 2 years, or by the time you get back, whichever is earlier. So let's assume if you take 6 months to come back, get back, then they pay you for 6 months. If you take 3 years to get back, then they pay you for 2 years. That's how it is.
So Ram Naray has a follow-up question. What are the documents that one needs to submit to prove that a person lost his or her job?
Okay. So in terms of the loss of job plans that we're speaking about, one obviously is you'll have to submit your loan-related documents as to what was your loan disbursed amount. And you would obviously have a loan statement, right? What is the EMI that you're paying and how much and so on and so forth. That's one of the things that the company would read, apart from the claim form that you need to fill up and your KYC documents that you need to submit. And apart from that, the other thing I think they would also require on a case-to-case basis is either the termination letter or the communication from the employer, along with few proofs about your salary and existing whatever was going on, credits that might happen. There might be some scenarios where, you know, the insurer might want to investigate a bit further and they might ask you to give a bank statement where the salary was getting credited from the company. So you can show them, okay, see, here's a bank statement where the salary was actually getting credited till last month, and this month onwards it is not getting credited. Or here is my PF statement where this is happening. So those are case-to-case basis, but broadly, if you claim form, KYC documents, and your loan proof that you have an EMI running, and the termination related documents. These are the broad documents, and then case-to-case basis, there might be a few documents that the insurance company might ask for.
So in certain cases, Sajja, what happens is that a company just shuts down and doesn't communicate anything to the employees. It just downs its shutters, and maybe eventually in the legal process, it decides to inform people. But there are certain cases we keep coming across.
Sure.
Where a company just shut down, and, you know,
in such scenarios, as I said, Vivek, see, there'll be scenarios where it might happen. The company just shuts down and shuts shop, and there's no communication whatsoever about what's going to happen. In those cases, the insurance companies will take a case-to-case call as to what documents would they require to figure out how can they pay a claim. Obviously, you know, they'll be very fair about, you know, they would also understand that if a company is just shut shop and there are no documents available, I'm sure they'll be, as to it happens, right, at times, in, you know, in case of certain claims, like, for example, the Hyderabad floods and other things that have happened. Let's assume your RC has got lost along with the car, because the car the car just went away in the flood, and the RC also went away with it. So they understand that, and then they would, you know, ask you to get a duplicate RC issued from RTO basis the same, or they would, you know, validate that with Parivahan, and then, you know, get your claim processed and so on and so forth. So then similarly, as I said, there'll be multiple things which will be there in place. So let's assume if you're working in some company, I'm sure your bank statement would show what is the salary that you were getting earlier, till which month did you get your salary, or your PF statement will show what is the PF that you got till date, created based the company that you're working on. You would have some salary slips in place. The other thing, I'm sure if such a company gets shut down, then there are obviously the news clippings and other stuff that goes on, right? Some legal related documents, which obviously the related to either the Labor Commission or a few other things. So proceedings that would happen. So I think these documents would be taken into consideration, and insurance companies would be very fair about those.
Okay. Manoj Kumar Singh has this question. Are there any chances of policy rejection?
Yes, so you know, basically, in case if you have a existing, let's assume, as I said, in case of a loss of income plan, specifically since it takes care of accidental disablement and certain stuff. So if you already have a disability, then you're not eligible for such plans. And there are obviously some risk categories where the insurance company either, you know, have a differential pricing basis the risk category of job, or some of the risk categories are currently not covered in these plans. For example, if you're working in mines, underground mines, or let's assume you're working at, you know, high tension electric wires related stuff, you know, certain jobs of those high risk nature kind of, these are certain things which would not be covered under these plans at this point of time. And but let's assume if you're a, you know, regular salaried person who's involved in regular office stuff, I don't think there'll be any conditions as such. But yes, as I said, if you have any.
We seem to have lost Sajjan. Sajjan, can you hear?
Yeah, I can hear you now. I think in between we lost you.
We lost each other for a bit. So there is a question from Azam Ali, and you just touched upon it. Are there any specified professions which are not listed for buying this policy? You said underground.
As I said, right? Yes. So there are specific certain profiles which are there, which are high risk related jobs basically occupations. This is different from insurance company to insurance company. So when you're buying this policy as part of the proposal, there are some listed jobs out there, and then there is, you know, anything which is not part of it is not allowed. Predominantly, these are only high risk jobs. As I just gave an example of, you know, someone who's working in, you know, say underground mines or coal mines, or you know, or at higher heights at higher altitudes, which might be related to electric tension wires or in the construction related machine operation kind of stuff, so on and so forth. These are the kind of risks generally which are not covered currently under these plans. And similarly, let's assume also these which are related to aircraft crew and all of that stuff, which are slightly higher in risk nature.
There's a question from Nagaraj. Is this available only online? What is the difference between buying it online versus offline?
Nagaraj, as I just touched upon when we started, right? So it's not that this is only available online. You can buy this from the insurance companies also offline. But I think one of the reasons, as I said, right, they're not so popular is predominantly the premium size are very, very small compared to any of the regular products, whether it's life insurance or health insurance. And hence, I guess, the listing of products or the, you know, option to purchase, I guess, is the routes to purchase offline have been lesser in nature. That's it. If someone is available who's selling these plans, you can definitely buy offline.
Sajja, we seem to have lost your audio. Sajja, can you hear me? Sajja, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
We lost your audio for the last 1 minute. If you can repeat yourself.
Sure. So I was saying, basically, you know, Nagaraj, there's nothing different in the plan as such between online and offline. You can purchase it offline as well. The only thing is, as I said, since the premium size is smaller in nature, I guess not many people are actually selling it offline. Otherwise, you know, you can just come. The benefit in online is, you know, everything is listed in black and white every day, everything on the website, because we're, you know, also registered entity with IRDAI, licensed entity with IRDAI, which is the insurance regulator. And everything is written in black and white. Whatever is written there is what's there in the policy copy. So you can compare all the plans of different companies and then accordingly choose whether you want to buy online or offline and which plan do you want to buy.
Mm. There's a question from Ashok Babar. Is it possible that I can buy this policy for my son? He will turn 18 in Jan 2021.
No, these plans, specifically, as I said, Ashok, are predominantly covering either a job, EMI, or income, or a salary, right? So he's going to turn 18, and hence I'm assuming, he's not working right now, and he does not have a salary or EMI in place or income in place, and so on and so forth, right? These are only applicable for people who are, already working and who have an income. In order to replace that income in case of a disablement that's occurring, in case of loss of income, in case of a loss of job, it's about, if someone is working and someone has an EMI, running EMI, and to take care of that EMI. So from what I can understand, I think this is not applicable for your son or for your kid at this point of time.
Anurag has a question. Is there any specific income limit or any other conditions?
So yes, the only income, the conditions, as I said, is I just explained some time back about loss of job plan has this for the first ever time when you're buying, you have a 3 months of waiting period. So that's one condition. The second thing is it should not be due to, your own resignation for whatever reason, or due to termination from the company due to fraud or dishonesty or poor performance. The income related part, yes, there are some plans which have income related conditions. Predominantly, the weekly benefit that you're going to get is a multiple of your annual income, right? So someone who might have a 50,000 rupees of salary a month will be able to take a 12,500 rupees of weekly benefit, but they will not be able to take, say, a 25,000 or a 40,000 rupees of weekly benefit. Similarly, someone who's having a, say, 20,000 rupees of monthly salary can take up to 5,000 rupees of weekly benefit. But if they want to take a 20,000 rupees of weekly benefit, that's like looking at profiting from insurance, which is not allowed. So these are the kind of conditions which are there. And automatically, when you enter your annual income and you select those details, this will be auto-populated basis there.
Rajesh has this question. Will it cover government employees also, or is it only for private sector employees?
So these plans, as I said, these don't vary between whether you're a government employee or a private employee. These are applicable for any kind of segments, whether it's the loss of job or loss. As I said, loss of income is for both salaries and employment, so there is no question about where it matters. And the specific loss of job thing that we are speaking about, it covers both segments. It does not differentiate between whether it's a government or a private employee kind of.
On the loss of income piece that you talked about, Sajja, is it only for self-employed or for salaried?
No, it is both for salaried and self-employed, the loss of income bit that I spoke about. See, it's about loss of income plans, which these plans basically will take care of your income or salary in case you have a disablement or disability, accidental disablement or disability which occurs with you and you're not able to go to your work. Mm-hmm. So in such a case, your income is being replaced by these plans.
All right, we leave it there. Thank you very much, all of you, for joining us and for your questions. This promises to be an exciting product, Sajja, and let's see how it plays out. And hopefully, again, after 2 or 3 months, we'll talk about how this has really played out and some of the new innovations around these plans that you said that insurance companies will do as we go along. But a great start. So thank you very much for joining us, Sajja, and wonderful talking to you. Thank you.
Thanks. Same to you. Yeah.